Hi there everyone, and let's check out one more chess game of Paul Morphy in the Paul Morphy's chess game series. And in this chess game, Paul Morphy is playing with the white pieces and his opponent is John Rhodes. So this game was also played in Birmingham, England in 1858. So Paul Morphy starts the game with playing e4, John Rhodes played e5, f4, King's Gambit, declined, bishop to c5. Knight to f3, knight to c6, f takes on e5, d5, e takes on d5, queen takes pawn, knight to c3, attacking the queen, queen to d8, knight to e4, now attacking the bishop, bishop to b6, c3, bishop to g4, d4, queen to d5, knight to f2, attacking the bishop, and in this position, John Rhodes played a risky move. Well, he played knight takes on e5, especially against a strong player like Paul Morphy. This move is a very risky move. Well, John Rhodes is sacrificing the knight. But Paul Morphy didn't capture the knight and he played queen to e2. Well, if d takes on e5, then bishop takes on f2. And if king takes bishop, then queen takes queen. So after knight takes on e5, we have queen to e2 pinning the knight. And this was the better move. Actually, this was the most accurate move, the most accurate defense. Bishop takes on f3, g takes on f3. And Paul Morphy is still attacking the knight. And Rhodes is losing. Well, John Rhodes played queen takes on f3 and then Paul Morphy captured the knight. That's check. And Paul Morphy is a piece up. King to f8, bishop to e2, attacking the queen. Queen to c6, rook to g1, targeting on g7. f6, defending, but then queen to g3, still attacking on g7. g6, defending, bishop to e3, rook to e8, king to d2, knight to e7. And Paul Morphy played bishop to d3, queen to d7, knight to g4. Well, Paul Morphy is attacking on f6 with the knight. So defending with the knight, defending and attacking. Rook from a to e1, defending. Paul Morphy is adding more protection to the bishop. And John Rhodes captures the bishop, knight takes on e3, rook takes on e3, queen to f7. And in this position, Paul Morphy played a very beautiful move. Well, he played knight takes on f6, sacrificing the knight. But we have rook takes on e3 by John Rhodes. Well, of course, if queen takes on f6, then rook to f1, winning the queen. The queen can't go anywhere. This is pinning the queen. So rook takes on e3, queen takes rook. And in this position, Paul Morphy is still threatening to play rook to f1 and rook to f1 would be a deadly move for black. And this is completely losing for John Rhodes. And that's why he played a desperate move. Well, he desperately captured the pawn, queen takes on a2. And after this move, there is a forced checkmate. Well, Paul Morphy played queen to e8, king to g7, and then knight to h5, check. How to defend? The only move, king to h6. And then Paul Morphy played queen to e3. Let's check again. And there is only two defense left for the black. One possible continuation is pushing the pawn and blocking the queen. But then queen takes pawn and that's checkmate. And the other possible continuation is what happened in the game. Well, Rhodes captured the knight, king takes on h5. And after this move, Paul Morphy checkmated John Rhodes in one move. Well, Paul Morphy played queen to g5, and that's checkmate. So after this move, John Rhodes stand up and shook Paul Morphy's hand and bowed with respect, like a true gentleman, and slowly He walked out, and he go outside, and rode a horse to his home. What was the major mistakes when John Rhodes was riding his horse to his home? He was probably thinking and asking questions to himself, but there was no answer. The only answer is that Paul Morphy was probably the strongest player of his era, and Rhodes was no match for Morphy. So this was checkmate. What a beautiful chess game by Paul Morphy. So I hope you have enjoyed watching this video, and I hope to see you next time. Take care.